Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to our lesson, that is Management of Natural Resources. So in yesterday's topic, we have talked about sustainable management. Okay, in that we have seen how management is required, sustainable management is required, and how equitable distribution should be done among all the layers of the society. Okay, so today we are going to have a talk on forest and wildlife. See, forest is what exactly? What is meant by forest? See, we are living in a rural area only. We are not living in a city area. So, we are quite acquainted with the forest and we know how is the life in the forest. But exactly we are not a forest dwellers. So, here I am going to express you some points related to the forest. Forest is the large area of land, right? Forest is the large area of land which is covered by trees, small trees, then big trees, then shrubs, then herbs and various kinds of varieties of grasses are present into the forest. So forest is the land which is covered by trees, herbs, shrubs and grasses. Understood? So what happens in the forest, students? Various kinds of plants and animals, means trees, are providing the environment and the climate for the various plants and wild animals to grow in a harmony. Okay, to live their life in a harmony, plants and trees are playing an important role into the forest. See, various kinds of plants and animals are living into the forest into the harmony, and that is called as a biodiversity. Biodiversity refers to flora, means the forest are rich in flora and fauna. Flora refers to plants and fauna refers to animals. So forest is the actually house for all kinds of plants and various kinds of plants, variety of plants and animals are living in harmony, and this their harmony maintains the ecological balance. Okay, so plants and animals can live in harmony into the forest for their easy life and living their life luxuriously into the forest because they have a proper climate into the forest to survive them well. Okay, so we are not new for the forest, because early man was the forest dweller only. He has started his life into the forest only. He was living in a cave, and caves are present into the forest. So early man started his life in the forest only. So early man is called as a forest dweller. He was a food gatherer, means he was gathering his food actually. He was not completely, means taking fruits and some roots he used to eat from the forest itself, right? So he was completely dependent on the forest for what clothing. He used to skin or bark of the trees he used to wear on his body, some leaves, some huge leaves he used to wear. So early man was completely dependent on the forest for food, for his shelter, as well as for clothing, for medicine, for various purposes he was completely dependent on the forest, right? And later on what happened, he started doing crops, means he understood how to do the farming. And so what he did, he started clearing some patches of the forest, okay? Because for the crops he needs some land, some area of land he required for growing crops properly. So what he did, he tried to clear some patches of the land and trying to do the crop production. But still, in rural areas, people know how the people are living into the forest. So, forests are playing an important role in our life. Okay, for what purposes forests are designed? There are three purposes, or there are three categories which forests are playing an important role. The first category, or first category for the forest to grow, is forests are providing us a various products. So productive purpose is the actually major reason for the forest to grow properly. Okay, so productive purpose, then regulatory purpose and the protective purpose. So here I am going to explain you in detail all kind of this category in detail. Okay, so first purpose of the forest is productive purpose. Productive means we are getting various kinds of the products which we use in our day-to-day life. We are completely dependent on the forest. This productive purpose will give you an idea. So here are some productive functions of the forest. Okay, what are those? Means forests are used for the productive purpose. Means we are getting various raw products to prepare our products, okay, which we use in our day-to-day life. What are those? Fuel bill. Students, you are knowing still some people in the rural areas, the people who are living in a village are completely depend on the firewood. Means they are going in the forest, collecting the dried wood and using it for the heating purpose, for cooking purpose, for their day-to-day activities. They are using it. Now gas stoves are introduced, but still some people are completely depend on the fuel wood. Means they are using wood as a fuel. Dried wood they are using, they are collecting into the May season for further use. For 4 months they are not getting because the wood is wet. So they are unable to get. So they are collecting that wood into the April and May. Still this practice, these are practicing into our villages. We are aware about it. Then fodder. Fodder means cattle and sheep are eating some kind of herbs, some kind of shrubs, as well as grass, means grazing. They are grazing their animals, okay? Farmers are grazing their animals into the forest, and they are completely, because various kinds of grass is available into the forest, and it contains the nutritious value for this livestock, okay? They are getting this is a side business, because these are the milch animal we are knowing, and milch animal require a nutritious food for their growth and to give a proper amount of milk and the good quality of the milk. So this milch animals are completely depend on the forest for their grazing purpose, okay, because the grass is quite available. Green grass is good for them, it contains a nutritious value. So fodder is for the cattle and for the sheep. Then timber. Timber is the which we use in the furniture. Specifically, we have a furniture which is made up of the wood, and that wood is made from the, that is called as a timber, and that timber is used for building our houses, right? Building our houses, then furniture it is used. It is used in the paper industry, that as well as it is used into the pulp, to make pulp, then sawmilling, right? So for various purposes this wood is used exactly, and that is called as a timber. More than 1500 species are now are on the way of extinction because of the timber. So because in India this is the large amount of trees are present which are used for the timber, and there are some examples which we use for the timber, that is teak plant, then sal plant, then sisal, devdar, oak, pine. These plants are especially used. Here are some species I have mentioned, but more than 1500 species are there of plants. All I have not mentioned. So more than 1500 species are present which are used for the timber, okay, and it is used to make a plywood. Now you are quite acquainted with the plywood, right? Plywood, then sawmilling, means which we make a furniture from it, then paper, and for the boards this timber is used. Later on, bamboo. Students, you are knowing bamboo plant. A small bamboo plant we are also having as a show plant in our home. But bamboo plants are used mostly into the northeastern and the southwestern parts of the India, because it is replaced. It's a substitute for the timber. Okay, some people cannot afford the furniture which is made from the timber. So these people can use, or this is also decorative. This bamboo has a decorative value. So this bamboo is used by the people, and it's a substitute for the timber. So it is used for the fodder also. When it is small, it is used. Panda animal, you are knowing this panda animal is using this completely immature bamboo plants is used by the panda. It's a food for the panda. Okay, then timber is used for the raw material for making baskets. You're knowing baskets we are making, as well as some chairs, some decorative furniture, for especially furniture purpose this is used. But it has not much strength, right? Like timber, it has not much strength. So it is said as a substitute for the plant, as well as in the paper and the pulp industry also the steam bamboo plants are used. Other productive purpose are grasses. Various kinds of, various kinds of grasses are used. The name of lemon grass and palm rose grass and coos grass is used for various number of purposes. These grasses are used, which we get from the forest. This is also one more important product of the forest, that is lemon grass, palm rose grass and the coos grass. These are the three variety of the grasses which are used for various purposes. Number of purposes it is used. Then later on fruits. Students, we are knowing fruits we are getting from the forest only. Means we are taking production of the fruits in our farm and all. But there are some number of fruits which are grown automatically. Automatically means they are growing naturally into the forest. Such as mango, coconut, orange, pear, jackfruit, as well as some wild fruits. Here we have a variety of fruits which you might not have seen also. So there are various kinds of fruits are grown into the forest. And the people who are living, adivasis we say, the people who are living into the forest are completely depend for their all needs on the forest. So they are also surviving depends on the fruits and the food which they get from the forest. So here are some examples, mango, coconut, oranges, peach, then pear, as well as jamun, you are knowing students. So these are all fruits getting from the forest itself. Later on medicinal. Students, there are some plants which have a medicinal values, okay? And that medicinal values which we are using to fight against diseases. Now you are knowing the issue of the coronavirus is going on and we are drinking various kinds of syrups now. We are making kadas, we say. We are preparing them by using various kinds of the medicinal plants only. In the morning, we dip all medicinal plants in it and we drink that tea. Even green tea and lemon tea, all it contains the things which are responsible to increase, to boost our immunity. So this is actually a boon we are getting from the forest. So here are some examples, that is tulsi, neem, this plants, then eucalyptus, various kinds of plants. We use various kinds of spices that we all get from the forest itself. Okay, you are knowing Britishers came here for the spices, to make the business of the spices. So our country is rich in flora and fauna. So we have a various kinds of varieties of plants, means medicinal plants in our India. Then fiber. Fiber is used for the jute, cotton, hemp, like these fibers are there, which is also used for number of purposes. Okay, and that products are also we are getting from the forest itself. Later on, essential oils. See, essential oil is actually extracted from their leaves. These oils are extracted from their leaves. And these leaves of, this is lemongrass oil. Then, and this lemongrass oil are various kinds of plants are there, which we extract the oils from their leaves. And that oil is used into the cosmetic industries nowadays in a large amount because it has some values. Okay, which are anti-aging and antioxidant properties are present in such oils. Anti-aging and antioxidant properties are present. Brightening, skin tightening properties are also present. So these are used into the, these are also we get from the forest itself. Okay, and it is used in the cosmetic industry. It is used into the soap as well as it is used into the pharmaceutical industries also nowadays. So this is also we are getting, or this is also a raw material to make this product from the forest itself. Later on leaves, bahunia and butia, leaves are used to make a place. See students, in olden days people were not, means if there would be some function into the family, people used to eat their food into the plates which are made from the leaves. So bahunia and butia are used, these plants, for making their plates, as well as various kinds of lac, students, you are knowing resinous material which is also used in for the decorative purpose. We can make some ornaments also from the lac, as well as gum dinka we say in Marathi. So that gum is also used for the food purpose, as well as latex is a milky white juice. That latex is also used into the rubber industry. So forests are used for the number of purpose. Whatever we are surviving, that is because of the forest. Because whatever products we are using, the raw material we get from the forest itself. So here I have completed the productive functions of the forest. Now we'll go for the regulatory functions of the forest. Now here are some protective functions. Just now we have gone for the productive functions. Now protective functions. How forests are protecting our lives. How forests are playing an important role for the protection of our lives. So students, you are knowing that forests are playing an important role for the ecological balance. Ecological balance is maintained by the forest. because forests have various kinds of food chain and food webs. So ecological balance is maintained due to the forest, right? So forests are conserving our ecosystem. Just now we have seen our ecosystem topic, in that we have seen everything. So conservation of ecosystem is because of only forest, because forests are providing for everyone, means the forest dwellers providing everything, and because of that the ecosystem is maintained and ecosystem is conserved, ecological balance is maintained because of the forest. So this is the one protective function of the forest. And second is maintain clean water. Students, you are knowing that forests are responsible for the rainfall, right? Because forest has trees, and these trees are growing very longer, and these trees are bringing precipitation, and these trees are responsible for oxygenating our climate too. Means this is, forest is the only source to give us oxygen. There is no other source to get oxygen from the environment. Forest and trees are, because their excelled product is oxygen, and that we use for our inhalation purpose. So that oxygenating climate is done by only forest. So maintaining clean water means bringing precipitation, bringing a good quality of rainfall is done by the forest. Okay, then next is prevent soil erosion. Because plants roots are holding the soil properly, right? Because of this, what happens? Soil erosion stops. As soil erosion stops, okay, soil erosion stops, then soil does not flow to the rivers, right? And because of that, what happens? It is checking floods. Checking floods means floods are, it absorbs all the water. Roots are absorbing all the water. And so that what happens? The situation of the floody situation risk is reduced due to the forest. As well as the leaves are falling on the ground, that leaves are covering the soil, and so that the water which is falling due to the rainfall, that water is falling above the leaves. This does not carry the leaves along with it. The leaves are covering the land, and because of that soil erosion is also stops because of the forest. So these things are very simple to understand, because we are living really in a luxurious life. We are having lavish life at our home. So we are quite unaware about it. But every person, every mankind should understand the importance of the forest. Then only we can, we will go move towards the conservation of the forest. So it prevents soil erosion, check floods, as well as the underground water table is also recharged because of the forest. Because soil erosion, then it absorbs the soil, then it absorbs the water, and because of it, what happens? Underground water table is also recharged, and we are away from the risk of the droughts even. Means there is no scarcity of the water in future because of the forest. So this is also important part. Then good climate by absorbing CO2. Just now I said you ki forests are giving us oxygen. Means forest is the only source, or trees is the only source to oxygenate the climate. And at the same time they are absorbing carbon dioxide, and which reduces the risk of the greenhouse effect as well as the global warming because of only and only forests. So every mankind and every, you are the now current generation, you should understand the importance of the forest, and we should not stop deforestation, and we must move towards the afforestation, as well as it provides the shelter, because we are living in houses. Likewise, there are various species of wild animals which do not have houses. They are completely dependent on the forest, right? Nowadays we have tried to attack on their houses, because we are trying to cut down the trees and trying to increase our everywhere our empire around here, we are trying to increase, so that it provides a shelter for various kinds of wild animals. So here I have completed the protective functions of the forest. Now we'll go for the regulatory functions of the forest. So in regulatory functions, we will see first maintain the balance of carbon dioxide and oxygen. We require oxygen and plants require carbon dioxide. So having various kinds of varieties of plants and animals, the maintenance of or the balance of oxygen and carbon dioxide is done by the forest. Then next, increase humidity as plants are more. And you are knowing this transpiration purpose done by the stomata. Means excess amount of water is thrown out through the stomatal pore. that excess water goes in the surrounding, right? So humidity is increasing. As humidity is increasing, it brings rainfall. You are knowing students water cycle, how the plants are responsible for the water cycle. So it brings an appropriate amount of a rainfall. Because of the humidity, because of the transpiration, it brings a rainfall and balances our water cycle even. Okay, so this is also one regulatory purpose. As well as it prevents air pollution because it is oxygenating the climate, right? It prevents air pollution and plants are good sound absorber too. So in a huge factories, in huge companies, they are growing huge plants around there because plants are good sound absorber too. Okay, they are checking air pollution also as well as good sound absorber. Because of the plants, the climate is getting clean and clear. Along with that, interference for the strong winds. Whenever the strong winds are coming, the strong winds are interfered by the this tall plants. Sometimes the tall plants are uprooted during winds. Just now we have taken experience of the Nisarga cyclone. But then too, its intensity is getting reduced because of the plants. At the same time, there are some plants are grown into the coastal region to check such kind of cyclones. So here are some regulatory functions of the plants. And the forests are increasing the aesthetic beauty of the nature, right? So various kinds of artists and all are influenced by the forest. They go in the forest. Meditation, yoga, pranayam, this is done. That for that also, it is the good place. Means people are going into the forest because in the forest there is complete calmness, and so that climate is very much essential as well as it's a good for the meditation, yoga and pranayam. So various peoples are going, you are knowing Vipassana is one kind of meditation, and this is also done into the climate, original climate, that is into the forest. So forests are increasing the aesthetic beauty of the nature, which is good for the artist and for the people who liked it. Okay, so we have to conserve the forest and our wildlife. Thank you very much.